Hey guys, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMware NSX Cloud, where I share step-by-step videos which may help you in your next deployment. So don't forget to like and hit subscribe button. So far in this series, we have completed bring up of management domain without AVNs. In this video, we will deploy edge nodes for hosting application virtual networks, which are actually overlay networks. To start deployment of edge nodes, we will log into our newly deployed SDDC manager. So let's start. Log into SDDC manager using SSO domain administrator. Remember, you have defined its password in bring up parameter Excel sheet. After successful login, I'm reducing web-based zoom so that all options are visible on my screen. Now navigate to workload domain on the left-hand menu and click on three dots next to our management workload domain. Select add edge cluster option and confirm that all prereqs are complete. On general info screen, we will provide edge cluster details, which includes MTU, ASN, tier 0 and tier 1 router names and their passwords. Remember, AS numbers provided here will be used as remote AS on your uplink devices for configuring BGP neighborship. Now define use of this cluster, size of appliance, high availability mode, and routing mechanism, whether we are going to use static routing or dynamic. We will choose application virtual networks for this cluster and eBGP for dynamic routing, and size of the appliance based on number of workloads it's going to manage. I'm using tier 0 high availability as active-active, however, you will define it based on the use case and design decisions. Now these are edge node and logical router settings. Provide fully qualified domain name and management range IP for edge node management. Two TEP addresses, tunnel endpoint IP, which creates tunnel between participating nodes. Along with, we will provide uplink VLAN and interface IPs. I have mentioned it in my blogs that planning is the most crucial stage for VMware Cloud Foundation. You need to be ready with all required information before we start deployment. As planning and preparation workbook has complete information which we populated at the planning stage, it is very much possible that we make mistake while entering certain details. Hence, do not forget to check entered information twice. Our edge nodes will be hosted in same subnet, hence we will choose layer 2 uniform cluster type. In case your design needs you to host edge nodes on two different subnets, then you should choose layer 2 non-uniform or layer 3 cluster type. Now fill in the BGP peer details along with the tier 0 uplinks. After filling all information, add edge node and start filling details for the second node of the cluster. Instead of FQDN, I have entered host name for the second edge node. So let me correct that information. Now I will update second edge node and we are good to proceed. At this screen, we can review entered information. If we still miss, then we might catch our mistake at the validation step. As I told you before, even if we miss typo errors. Validation do help till some extent to avoid them. Now I will first correct the information and will rerun the validation so that we can start deployment. Let's run the validation again. Now we are ready to start deployment of the edge nodes. Meanwhile edge nodes are deploying, I will configure depot user credential for downloading bundles for further deployment. Depot user doesn't have to be an account which has all privileges on your My VMware portal. This is just an account created on Customer Connect portal of VMware. After account is configured and authorized, it will take approximately 15 minutes before bundles are listed for download. Till the time list is getting downloaded, let's check the progress of the deployment task. Let's schedule the download of bundles which we will deploy as a part of VMware Cloud Foundation deployment. Remember, we will only download bundles which are part of 4.3 version bill of material. You can schedule download of remaining bundles and validate if the deployment of edge node cluster is complete from the dashboard task list window. With the deployment of edge node cluster, I'm concluding this video. If you have any suggestion or feedback, do write it in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.